Welcome, everyone. Welcome, everyone, to Southwestern Oregon Community College, the Oregon Coast Culinary Institute class completion ceremony. Yay! We want to thank you all for coming. We believe, doing a calculation back here, that we believe this is our 10th class completion ceremony here at the college. Program started in 1999, and in the beginning it was a two-year program that we've now condensed down to 11 months of classes and then a three-month externship. So the students behind me have completed 11 months worth of classes, 90 hours of instruction, and now they're going to go out into the big world to do their externship. Some of them will stay here with us or stay locally, and a lot are going to go out to parts unknown to essentially go into the field, work under certified chefs, and enhance their skills, complete an additional training, then they'll be eligible to receive their two-year degree in culinary arts or baking and pastry. And I would just like to challenge you guys that are sitting behind me, and none of them have knives right now, to complete that externship. What we're finding is that once students leave the day-to-day love of having all of us around to make sure that they get to class and come for a 4 to 8 hour day, that they're challenged to finish that last piece. And many of them don't come back in June to go through graduation when you get your actual graduation certificate and you get to walk in a cap and gown. And I would just encourage you, I'd like to see more of you complete the actual two-year degree and come back to Southwestern in the spring and go through graduation, because it's a fabulous ceremony. And then all of you guys can come back and be part of that ceremony with the rest of the students who attend here. The baking and pastry students represent about 13% of the students who attend here. They are the largest, combined between the two programs, the largest program of study that we have, and we're very proud to have them here. I look forward to the students coming every year, and I always wonder what kind of interesting and new culinary treats am I going to eat during this year. And I'll be happy to report that this year, for the first time, I had cucumber sorbet made with cucumbers from the garden that we have a garden here. We grow things, teach the students how to take it from garden to the table. And then the other thing that I had that I've never had before was lobster corn dogs. And first I thought that was a waste of a good piece of lobster meat, having lived on the East Coast for a number of years, but it actually is pretty appetizing and was quite good. So that's one of the treats that we have here, is we have these fabulous chefs that are extremely creative and come up with these phenomenal, cool, wonderful tasting treats, and then we teach the students how to do it, and the students also come up with those kind of treats that they share with the rest of us. So we just love having the program here on campus. We're very happy that all of you were able to come and celebrate with us today. After this ceremony here, you'll get to go to the culinary arts facility and enjoy the treats that the students, they get to complete their ceremony, and they get to do all the work to make all the food for all of us to enjoy. Now, how's that work? So thanks again for coming, and I'd like to introduce you to the executive chef and the director of the culinary program, Chef Hanlon.
Thank you. Good morning and welcome. First thing I'd like to do is honor our instructors that work so hard with all of these students. All right, I'm going to mention our baking and pastry instructor, Chef Tina Powers. Chef Daryl Folk. Chef Nilda Duval. Chef Woojay Pointer, who you can't see behind the curtain. There he comes. He's got his camera. Chef Tom Roberts, who's been here since the beginning of the program. And up behind you, I wanted to correct Dr. Scott just for one thing. The students from our spring cohort are working on the food for the event this afternoon after our display here. And Chef Torres is working with them. He's up behind us, and he just wanted to say hello. And that brings me to our keynote speaker. I'm very honored to introduce Bert Catino. He is a certified executive chef. He is a member of the American Academy of Chefs. He's on the honorary board of trustees for the Academy. And I'm just honored to have him here. He is the owner of the Sardine Factory, and he will inspire our students as they prepare to be off on their culinary and baking adventures. Thank you. Welcome him.
Good morning. It's a great pleasure for me to be here. And I just want to say before I do speak on anything that I have a relationship with this area. Many years ago in 1933, there was a fishing boat from Monterey that came up here, and there was two fishermen on it. One was my father and one was my future father-in-law. And they always talked about Coos Bay and about the fishing here. And I had a great opportunity today to go down there and see Coos Bay and see the boats. And it really made me feel at home. So it was, in a sense, very nostalgic in that sense for me. But I was I certainly wanted to thank Sean Hamlin and of course, Randy Torres for inviting me for this wonderful opportunity to speak to you and also to address the students. And to the students, I want you to give yourself an applause for what you have accomplished. And we also know without this day, you could not do it with the family and the support. So let's give them an applause for supporting you. Just briefly on my background, I didn't really pick a career to be a chef. My destiny probably was going to be on one of those fishing boats. My family goes back to 1600 in the commercial fishing industry from Italy. And when my family came to Monterey, the sardine industry was prevalent, and part of my family certainly were instituting that industry. However, at a ripe age of 13, the opportunity was to go on the boat, and this was 1952, and unfortunately the industry collapsed, and that was my family's livelihood. And what are you going to do? Well, I went to wash dishes. My brother gave me an opportunity. He was a lifeguard at a guest ranch in Carmel Valley, and he says, "You want to make 30 cents an hour?" And I says, "Wow, 30 cents an hour. Absolutely." And except I'd have to be out there for 3 months during the summer, which would be great, because he says, "Look it, you can ride horses, you can come to the pool, you can see the girls at the pool." Oh, gee, that was a great con job, let me tell you. Well, when I got there, I washed dishes by hand, 3 meals a day. I didn't see daylight. Now, you think that was going to be a deterrent to me, but it wasn't. And I got an opportunity to work with a great chef there and then started working really in the industry and working in the profession. I went through a 3-year apprenticeship course and through the ACF, which was a great inspiration for me as well. And with that, I eventually worked many places and got an opportunity to open up my own restaurant in my hometown. A dilapidated old building down on Cannery Row that was now defunct. The places were all falling apart. It's the only place I could go where I can rent something that was inexpensive. And fortunately, with my partner, we were able to put this restaurant, and he says, look, it's only 50 seats. I says, 50 seats is enough to start with. And fortunately, that became a very successful operation for us. And we eventually bought the property. And of course, they say that was history. In any event, it was an opportunity and to open other restaurants, which we did. And I learned one thing, that to get qualified people was certainly very difficult. People that had some form of training. You know, as you open up restaurants, you begin to need more and more talented people. And that was certainly lacking in our area. And you know, today it costs quite a bit of money to train people. And most industries, as far as restaurants, hotels, they're going to grab what they can from the schooling, from the schools. The schools are certainly the most important area that we need to have, and certainly have students who are trained properly in all the different skills in relationship to the profession and to the industry. So we're very fortunate to have that. In fact, you know, this Mill Hotel down here was, I was pleased and surprised that the chef there, Dan Cattaneo. Dan, where are you? Dan Cattaneo worked for me in the early years, assisted me with my restaurants and did a great job, and it was great being with him last night and, of course, this morning. You know, in building a business, of course, you learn the value of the educational aspect. And the students who come out of the culinary schools need to understand that when they graduate from these schools, they're not chefs. They're beginning to go on that road. They're beginning to learn from that experience and continue with their experiences. You will continue with your education way beyond your school education. And you'll work with many different chefs who have different attitudes, different ideas, different philosophies. Those experiences can be pro and con for you. You may not really enjoy or understand in some cases, but you need to be objective, very objective. You have to certainly be in an environment that you can really show yourself, show what you can do. Don't be afraid to express yourself. Keep your integrity in the profession. Be professional. And you know, in many of the places that they'll end up be working at, they'll be working with other people who didn't go to a culinary school, but who are able to produce, able to perform. And you're going to say, well, I went to culinary school. I should deserve more money, or I should be able to be accepted. You have to prove yourself. I know there's many students that I have taken in through the years through externship. And externship to me is so important, and I'm glad to see that they're going to go out in the real world and experience that. And learning and working and interacting through the process of human relationships with these other people, understand where they are coming from and understand the job that you are asked to do. Don't be afraid, again, like I said, to express yourself. You know, quality is a very much a key point in anything we do. In my operations at the time, I kept thinking, if I buy the best, and if I prepare it well, and I serve it in a great environment, it's going to be a success. And that's why the other point is value of certification. Certification has become more acceptable and more needed in our industry. You know, we had a professor from Cornell once at our National Chefs Convention get up there and told us that, you know, we probably poison about 6 million people a year, something we don't want to hear. Cross-contamination is one of our biggest enemies. To be certified as a chef today and go through the level of certification, you have to take a practical and a physical test to pass. And this is good. And still, the failure rate on cross-contamination is one of the most important keys to the failure of that acceptance of certification. We now have certification in the American Culinary Federation that many of us belong to. This is over 20,000 members. And advise the students to get involved, to go through the process of certification, become certified, and that would give you a greater opportunity in your career. You know, you're going to find mentors and who you work with. You probably have mentors in some cases even now. I found mentors. I was mentored by a chef by the name of Warren LaRuth. Maybe a lot of you never heard of him. But if you've heard of Seven Seas Dressing or Popeye's Chicken, he was the creator of all that. And he was a chemist, and he was General Mark Clark's personal chef after the Second World War. And Warren was just a fantastic chef because he had that ability to really produce and to really was a tremendous icon in the industry. And I think, students, you need to find your mentors and continue with your studies. Continue to learn. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid of making a mistake. Making a mistake is all part of the learning experience. That will give you an opportunity to project yourself into better positions and maybe in your careers. I know some of you look at TV and look at all the celebrity shows. I've cooked on with Rachel Ray. I've cooked with Bobby Flay. Cooked with some of the celebrity chefs. Even had a TV show for a while. It's great. It looks good. But that's not the real world. The real world is in the trenches out there, in the kitchens of the hotels and the restaurants. That's where the career really becomes in focus. So it's important to be success. You got to be dedicated, and you got to be willing to sacrifice. And sacrifice today is not easy because lifestyles are a little different. I don't know. With myself, and I know a lot of chefs I talked to, we ended up having great lifestyles. We went through it. You work holidays. You know, you can't go to the game. You can't do some of those things. But if you really have the passion, and the word is passion, and a love of the profession, you will be a success. I'll guarantee you you'll be a success. But if you don't love it, don't stay in it. Maybe you should have even gone through the school. But when you do get those rewards with the accomplishments that you make, it is so rewarding and so great. Money has not been the answer to it all. It's a feeling of making it and reaching your goals in your life. And always set new goals in your life. You can do it. You have to be willing to do it. Use your common sense. You know, years ago, this profession, we were considered domestics. Can you believe that? The chefs were not considered professional until 1977, where the American Culinary Federation changed that, and we got accepted by the government. So I think, you know, you have a legacy. You got a history that you could evolve with, and you can make these great successes and accomplishments. I just want to leave you with one thing. The greatest chef is yet to be born. The greatest meal is yet to be served. It's infinity. It's ongoing. You are the stars of tomorrow, whatever world you're going to be in, whatever restaurant, whatever hotel, whatever, even in education and giving back, which is another tremendous way of promoting our profession for the future. You have just begun. God bless you, and good luck on your career. I'm proud of every one of you.
Thank you, Chef Catino, for those words of wisdom. Next, we would like to welcome Kim Ream and BJ Sanchez to the podium. These are two of our students who are going to briefly synopsize their time here. Thank you very much.
We brought our mise en place, because I'm sure I'm going to need it. All right, well, someone's told me that we are our own best investment, and we pay to come to college. So in a sense, when we choose to come to college, we are employing our instructors. And I believe this has made me a businesswoman. And I have to say, I do not know of anyone that has employed a staff and been told by their employees when to come in, when to leave, what to wear, and no jewelry. Well, I've been told what to do for the past 2 years, and while I think that I have spent my money very wisely, I know without a doubt that I've hired some of the best chefs in the business, and I'm proud and thankful that they have chosen to give back by teaching us what they love. I love my time at OCCI so much that when I was done with the culinary program, I also decided to take the baking and pastry. I knew this would be a challenge, and I don't know why I put myself out of my own comfort zone, knowing that the chefs pushed me out enough. But Chef Torres once told me that when you are out of your comfort zone, you are learning. So I have a few do's and don'ts that I have learned in the kitchen. Do not under-season or over-season your food. Always taste your food. Do not lean, because if you lean, you can clean. Do not eat goat cheese. And if you do, try it at least 10 times, try to trick your taste buds into liking it. Do not assume and always ask questions. Do not ever forget to thank the culinary students for the protein, and always share your sweets with them. Do not be afraid to try anything, because practice does make perfect. And now I have some people to thank, and first I want to thank my husband for supporting the many hours that I put in, and it helped that he understands the business, and I love that he cleaned house, did laundry, and even shucked peas for me, and I love you. To all my beautiful daughters, thank you for not making me feel guilty for missing birthday parties and telling my grandbabies that Nana loves and misses them. Thank you for being supportive of my decision to do what I love, even though it has taken me away from what we were all used to. To my newfound friends, I am richer at heart to have gotten to know all of you. And for the chefs, I will start with Chef Hanlon. Thanks for caring, and I love who you are. And I will always think of you when someone tells me to wrap it up. Chef Torres, you took me out of my comfort zone more than I care to remember, and I thank you for that. Because of you, I will always remember to manage my time, after I harvest my farm, of course. And Chef Duval, you have the most beautiful spirit, and well, you know, I have to say, c'est la vie. Chef Uje, yes, ma'am, I kind of got used to it. But that sexy definitely stuck. Chef Powers, I have your number. You're just a big softy. And I will always work smarter, not harder. Chef Folk, or should I say Chef D, there are so many things I could say. But to sum it up, I'm going to say bang, bang, bang. And Chef Roberts, there are truly more than 5 reasons why I love you. And the number one reason is your Thai tacos. Jamie and Tara, you are the best, and I will miss our talks. And Dustin, you are my right-hand man, and I hope I can work with just my left. Thanks for the hugs. My culinary teammates, yes, I miss our time together. I will always miss our time together. And I will truly miss my culinary family, and all of you know what family means to me. All I can say is thank goodness for Facebook.
Good job, Kim.
Good luck, BJ.
Thank you. Okay, I really don't know why I'm up here because I'm actually... I know nobody's going to believe this, but I'm actually scared. I'm told to relax. This is the last time they're going to get to push me around and push me out of my comfort zone. So welcome everyone to the Oregon Coast Culinary Institute celebration. It's a great honor for me to stand up here and speak with you, and congratulations to all the OCCI students. On behalf of all the students and myself, I want to thank each and every one of the chef instructors for their knowledge, their understanding, and their overall exceptional teaching abilities that made us who we are right now and who we hope to be in the future. You are truly amazing in what you do, and for that we all thank you. Of course, we do have to take note on a couple of things, like Chef Roberts. We do love you and respect you so much. He can take a quiet room full of concentrating culinary students and create comedy hour, usually on me. And Chef Folk, oh yes, we all know, bang, bang, bang.
Yeah.
So unexpected and so loud that laughter lingers behind somewhere every time. And Shantae, no matter what Chef Robert says, I do love you. The times we spent here has always been fulfilling with each instructor, and you've all left us with a little something. We all have great memories here that we will take with us. For me, one of my many is Tara, Jamie, Kristen, and Chef Hanlon. I do know if not for these four in the beginning, the middle, and the end of my education here, it would have not been very smooth. So with that comes a big thanks to you all. Some of us have taken the culinary course and some the baking and pastry, and some of us have taken both, and a few of you will be returning for a second round. I could really think of no better place to do it. It's a great school. It takes skill, hard work, dedication, and experience to become a great chef. We have already started on this journey through our education, and I'm certain that each and every one of us will achieve what we desire to accomplish. Learn to appreciate what you do understand. In order to grow, you need to constantly educate yourself both within the kitchen and outside. I've made lots of friends here. I've gained lots of respect for the staff, and somehow, I've gained a lot more children than I thought I already had. Thus, the nickname, Mama Bear. Thank you, Amelia. I know we are all excited to go out and start our externships and become great chefs. Many of you will go to your hometowns, and some will venture out to unknown territory. Wherever you decide to go, I want to leave you with this. Always be a champion in spirit and mindset, and remember to love what we do and to do what we love. We are chefs. Thank you.
Everybody has been so eloquent that parts of my speech will be redundant. And people that have seen this a few times know that bits of it have been repeated, but I really don't have a problem with that. So this is the speech. And many of you remember back in the end of September, I mentioned some of this, so I'm going to mention it again. And I told you that I would. So, once again, welcome family, friends, advisory committee, faculty, administration, and College Board of Education, and of course, the students. And now we say to these students, I say, congratulations, you did it. You've completed the first step in your culinary career, your formal education in culinary arts and baking and pastry. Now you are off to complete your externships in the field and then become graduates in your chosen craft. Now it is time for the real world. You will always be students of the craft, but your responsibilities have now changed. You are now on your way up the industrial ladder. Your work ethic and habits will dictate your success. Remember, if you keep working hard, people will believe in you, and then there will be no limit to what you can do. Tara added that line last year. We have spoken to all of you throughout this last year about what it takes to be successful in your passion for food and the true reward of mastering this craft. In closing, I want to leave you with these words once again. Listen. Remember. Write down. Ask questions. Practice. Learn the basics. Develop a style. Stay humble. Keep listening. Continue your education. And most importantly, give back to others. Keep these fundamentals in your pocket for the passage that lies ahead. Let us now honor our students for their accomplishments. Chef Powers, Chef D. We will start with the bake and pastry students. Christopher Birdie.
You need a hat and a medal. Come right this way.
Are they going to get it? Okay.
Yep.
Congratulations.
Carly Bratton. Bratton.
We're proud of.
Congratulations. Hannah Brown. Dylan Correa. Jennifer Dietrich. Rianne Dodge. Did I say that right, Rianne? Ferguson. April Foster. John Foster. Mandy Fraley. Ashley Frankie. Mr. Garman, Bob Garman. Bob went through both programs. Robbie Gibson.
Thank you. Great job. Thank you. Thank you.
Alexandria Hansen. Jessica Herman.
I love this.
Hmm? Robert Hunt. Robert also went through both programs. Aaron James. Diana Jeffs. Diana was on our national culinary team, and she's headed to Houston to work with Darren Aoyama, one of the best pastry chefs in the country. Nicole Kuryatnik. Trisha Marker. Larissa Mueller. Nelson. Michelle Poteet. I'm going to try my best. Alexis Quiroga. Kim Ream. Kim Ream was also on our national culinary team. And hopefully is headed to Google, correct? Schroeder. Nicolene Simpson. Streisner. Kenyon Suwa. Taylor. I think Carly is headed to Reno to do her apprenticeship with an ACF certified chef. Amanda Weber. Weber. Sarah Wedlake. And last but not least in baking and pastry is Dustin Wieland. Thank you. Yeah, we're going to do those next. Chef Roberts, Chef Duvall. We will start the culinary portion with Monica Almond. Joseph Araujo. I did okay with that, right, Justin? Justin Brown. Justin Clark. Justin was also a member of our national culinary team. Connor. Brandon Couch. Tyler Craspe. Mallory Crocker. Mallory was also a member of our culinary team, and she's headed to Hawaii to work. Martin DeFriend. Ryan Ekstrom. Richard Estevez. Rebecca Fall. Sean Flowers. Crystal Gallivan. big growth. Daniel Hart. Timothy Higley. Kayla Holden. Jillian Howell. Alex Jameson. Shante Kraska.
I love you, Boo.
Edwin Lara. There was a couple of times that Edwin was going to leave us. He didn't want to stay through the whole thing, but I'm glad he did. Yeah. Curtis Latourelle. Jennifer Liggett. Mackenzie Lindsay. Mackenzie is one of our students who's coming back to do Chef's Table for us. Brittany Lira. Thomas Marcinick. Look at that haircut. That is awesome. I didn't recognize you.
Thanks,
Jeff. Scott Mast. Aaron McKinley. Orr. George Pierce. Joshua Perkins. Yeah. Cameron Rapp. Amelia Rombach. Benjamin Rosenbaum. Ben has worked with Chef Chris in dining services, and he's an accomplished ice carver now, and I think he's going to try to go to Alaska this year.
Congratulations.
Jalika Salee. Mayumi Salee. BJ Sanchez. I was going to say Betty, but Quincy Sanders. No, I almost said Charles.
There you go.
Joelle Simler. Kelsey Stofelf. Doesn't Kelsey have nice shoes on today?
Nice try.
So I butchered that one, and now this one comes up next. Kamwendo Tembo. Brandon Toner. Jesse Vaughn. Brandon Vesperman. Alex Wheeler. Megan Whitson. Douglas Williams. Students also wanted me to mention a classmate of theirs who unfortunately passed away this winter. Megan Mojica received a degree posthumously. Let's all give her a round of applause. I know all the chefs can attest to one of the most important things in our profession is attendance. Punctuality, right after that. We have, it looks like, quite a few awards for perfect attendance, which I'm always impressed by the number we get every year. These people showed up every single day to class on time. Chef Powers, Chef D, can you come up and give the Bake and Pastry Perfect Attendance Awards?
We won't need a mic.
I don't know. Okay, well, let's make sure that in this list. Oh, yeah. All right.
Yeah.
Is this the right list?
Yeah. Trisha Marker. Amy Schroeder. Ferguson. Carly Taylor.
Plus a little extra.
Diana Jeffs. Larissa Mueller. Michelle Poteet. Kim Ream. Suwa. Amanda Weber. Dustin Wieland. DJ Sanchez.
Just these four. Okay. California, Kenny, Ben, Jillian.
You know what? There was one more baking pastry student.
Oh.
Chris Birdie.
Come on up.
Sorry about that. Chef Duvall, the culinary students now.
Mm-hmm.
BJ Sanchez.
Yeah. Oh,
she already got it.
Thank you.
Cam Tembo.
Yeah.
Benjamin Rosenbaum. And Jillian Howell. In closing, I would like to welcome a good friend of mine, Dr. Stephen J. Crittlebaugh. He was the president when OCCI was created, and he'd like to say a few words to finish up here.
Well, how's everybody out there today? What are you doing? I didn't hear a damn thing. Stand up and recognize your family member, your student. Well, thank you. We finally saw some smiles up here from these people. I was beginning to think that I was at a funeral. Can you smile? You can't. Ah, you did. I'd like to have you stand up now and thank your family members, your spouses, your friends for supporting you. You know, as president emeritus of the college and one of the creators of this Culinary Institute over 10 years ago, I'm really proud and honored to be with these students today to share in their success. I'm sure that there were times throughout this past year when these students thought that the year was never going to end, and now they don't know where the past 2 months have gone. I do know one thing, they're no worse for the wear and tear that they've taken this year, and they are now completing their formal schooling and entering their profession as a culinary chef or a pastry chef, and in some cases, both. Education is one of the most wonderful things that we can do for ourselves, for our families, for our children. You know, education is the one thing that no one can ever take away from you. And that's what you've achieved this year. I want to recognize all of you for that. I want to congratulate you for doing that. And I hope that you had a wonderful time here at the Culinary Institute and at the college. You know, many things have changed in the world. And in fact, in the past few days, you probably don't want to turn the television on because of the news that's being reported. But there are a lot of things that don't change in the world. They're relatively constant, and they're relatively important that we recognize what they are. It's hard work. It's perseverance. It's honesty and integrity, and it's creativity and education. The accomplishments of OCCI this year and students are something that when the Institute was a gleam in my eye, I could not seeing be achieved. Chef Hanlon told you that there were, I think, about 5 or 7 students up here that had participated in the culinary team that competed in the state. They won that. They competed regionally, and they won that competition. And about 2 weeks ago, they were in Dallas at the annual convention of the American Culinary Federation, where they came in second.